10 events that happened on May 19. 1. On 1743, Jean-Pierre Christin, a French physicist, mathematician, and astronomer, made a pivotal advancement in the field of thermometry. Christin took the existing thermometer, which was invented by Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit, and introduced a new temperature scale, known today as the Celsius scale. The Celsius scale, also referred to as the centigrade scale, defines the freezing point of water as 0 degrees and the boiling point as 100 degrees under standard atmospheric conditions. This improvement was a radical departure from Fahrenheit's scale, which defined these points at 32 and 212 degrees respectively. Christin's invention not only simplified temperature measurement, but it has also become the standard for scientific work worldwide, despite the United States, Belize, and Palau predominantly using the Fahrenheit scale. 2. On 1881, a significant figure in Turkish history, Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, was born in Thessaloniki, then a part of the Ottoman Empire, now Greece. A skilled army officer and a visionary leader, Atatürk rose through the ranks of the Ottoman military, displaying tactical prowess that marked him as a future national leader. The same date, 38 years later, on May 19, 1919, symbolizes a pivotal turning point in Turkish history, as Atatürk set in motion the Turkish War of Independence. This was a response to the partitioning of the Ottoman Empire following World War I by the Allies of the Triple Entente, a plan that Atatürk and his followers vehemently rejected. Atatürk led the nationalist movement against the occupying forces, a struggle that lasted 4 years, and resulted in a victory that laid the foundation for modern Turkey. Upon the war's successful conclusion, the Republic of Turkey was founded in 1923, replacing the Ottoman Sultanate that had been in existence for over 600 years. Mustafa Kemal Atatürk then became the first president of the new republic, marking the beginning of an era of extensive political, legal, and social reforms known as Kemalism. Atatürk's leadership drastically transformed Turkey into a modern, secular, and democratic nation, and his legacy continues to shape the country to this day. 3. On 1890, a figure who would leave an indelible mark on Vietnamese and world history was born, Ho Chi Minh, initially named Nguyen Xanh Cung. Rising from humble beginnings in a small village in central Vietnam, he traveled extensively, gaining political and revolutionary ideas that would shape his leadership. Ho Chi Minh played a pivotal role in the anti-colonial movement in Vietnam, and he eventually founded the Viet Minh Independence Movement in 1941. After the August Revolution in 1945, he declared the independence of Vietnam from France, subsequently serving as the first president of the Democratic Republic of Vietnam, now known as North Vietnam. Ho Chi Minh, a symbol of Vietnamese resilience and independence, died in 1969, but his influence lives on, memorialized by the city that now bears his name, Ho Chi Minh City. 4. On 1925, a figure destined to leave an indelible mark on the fight for civil rights in America, Malcolm X, was born in Omaha, Nebraska. Born as Malcolm Little, his transformative journey began early, as he navigated racial prejudice, crime, and imprisonment, before converting to the Nation of Islam while in jail. Malcolm X emerged as a fervent advocate for African Americans, challenging both the rampant racism of the time and the more moderate approach to civil rights advocated by figures like Martin Luther King Jr. His forceful speeches and charismatic leadership served to highlight the systemic injustices faced by Black Americans, giving voice to frustrations and demands for equal rights. Despite his assassination in 1965, Malcolm X's influence endures, his life and teachings continuing to inspire movements for Black power, self-determination, and racial justice. 5. On 1945, Pete Townshend, a musician who would leave a lasting impact on the world of rock and roll, was born in Chiswick, London, England. From a young age, Townshend showed an affinity for music, a passion that would lead him to co-found one of the most influential rock bands of the 20th century, The Who, in 1964. As the primary songwriter and lead guitarist for The Who, Townshend was the driving force behind seminal albums such as Tommy and Quadrophenia, introducing the concept of rock operas to the music world. Townshend's dynamic stage presence, exemplified by his signature windmill guitar move, and his willingness to experiment with the boundaries of rock music set him apart as a trailblazing artist. Over the decades, Pete Townshend's contributions to music as a singer-songwriter and guitarist have made him an enduring icon in rock and roll, influencing countless musicians who followed in his footsteps. 6. On 1959, the North Vietnamese Army took a strategic step towards supporting their allies in the South by establishing Group 559. This specialized unit, composed of soldiers and engineers, was tasked with the crucial mission of determining the most effective way to maintain supply lines to South Vietnam amidst a politically fraught landscape. The monumental task involved bypassing natural obstacles, dodging enemy forces, and ensuring the safe passage of troops and essential supplies, all while maintaining secrecy. The outcome of Group 559's work resulted in the establishment of the Ho Chi Minh Trail, an intricate network of paths and tunnels spanning across Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia. The trail played a pivotal role in the Vietnam War, allowing the North to supply their Viet Cong allies in the South, and remains a testament to the strategic planning and resilience of the North Vietnamese Army. 7. On 1962, Marilyn Monroe attended a gala at Madison Square Garden, New York, to celebrate President John F. Kennedy's upcoming birthday. Draped in a shimmering, tight-fitting dress, Monroe captivated the audience, making her entrance late into the night. The actress stepped up to the microphone and delivered a sultry, breathy rendition of "Happy Birthday, Mr. President," a twist on the traditional "Happy Birthday" song. Monroe's sensual performance, full of charisma and enchantment, added a layer of intrigue to the already swirling rumors about her affair with JFK. Monroe's iconic rendition of "Happy Birthday" went down in history, solidifying her image as a major sex symbol, despite being one of her final public appearances before her tragic death later that year. 8. On 1963, the New York Post Sunday magazine published a significant document that had profound influence on the civil rights movement, Martin Luther King Jr.'s Letter from Birmingham Jail. This open letter, written by King while he was incarcerated for his role in nonviolent demonstrations against segregation, argued eloquently for civil rights and racial equality. In the letter, King defends the strategy of nonviolent resistance to racism, responding to white religious leaders who had criticized him as an outside agitator, and called for a more gradual approach to integration. This profound and passionate call for justice, with its famous assertion that "injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere," resonated deeply with readers across the nation and the world. The publication of the letter in the widely read New York Post Sunday magazine significantly amplified King's message, contributing to the momentum of the civil rights movement and solidifying King's role as a leading voice for racial equality. 9. On May 19, 1977, Natalia Oreiro, who would become a prominent figure in the worlds of music and acting, was born in Montevideo, Uruguay. From an early age, Oreiro pursued her passion for performing, a journey that would lead her to become a well-known singer-songwriter and actress not only in her native Uruguay but also internationally. In the realm of music, Oreiro's impactful songs and distinctive style have made her a beloved figure in the Latin pop genre, with her talent as a songwriter resonating with audiences worldwide. In addition to her musical achievements, Oreiro has also made a significant impact in the world of acting, captivating audiences with her performances in various films and television series, and establishing herself as a respected and versatile actress. 10. On 2018, a royal wedding took place in St. George's Chapel at Windsor Castle in England, uniting Prince Harry, the younger son of Prince Charles and the late Princess Diana, and Meghan Markle, a former American actress. The wedding, a blend of traditional British pageantry and modern multiculturalism, represented a significant departure from typical royal weddings, showcasing the couple's commitment to diversity and inclusivity. The ceremony was watched by an estimated global audience of 1.9 billion people, underscoring the enduring fascination with the British royal family and the international popularity of the couple. The wedding, steeped in symbolism, included a passionate sermon on the power of love by Bishop Michael Curry, the first African-American to serve as presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, and the gospel choir singing, "Stand By Me." The wedding of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, encapsulating change and tradition, has since been remembered as a historic moment that redefined what a royal wedding could be. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like and notification buttons. Subscribing would greatly support me. and it's completely free. Also, feel free to leave your comments below.